Hi, we're Grisfolk, and we're talking to you for a magazine. We all met in Los Angeles. We were working on different projects, we were all really good friends, and we just pulled it all together and, you know, formed this thing called Grisfolk that we are now traveling. It's a traveling show now.
It started as a nickname we had for Adam. We called him Gris Adams back in the day, and when we started the project, we call it Gris Adams, and after a while we thought, wow, this is something that we want to pursue and make a band, and we came up with the name Grisfolk to incorporate, you know, more of the community of people around us and families and friends that have helped us on the way.
Great.
It opened a lot of doors for us and led to, you know, playing bigger shows and touring and in cities that we never really thought we'd be in, and now we're just a traveling band. Well, we were trying to come up with a concept, you know, for, we've seen a lot of lyric videos before, you know, and like, you know, sometimes they're a little cheesy, you know, but we wanted to do something that was more of a collaboration with another artist. And it was just an idea we had that just popped in our head. We're like, why don't we find a great street artist to just do, to help us out with it? And her name is Jules Muck, and she does some really cool stuff in Venice and kind of all over the world now, but she lives in Venice, and pretty much every corner in Venice has a Jules Muck stamp on it. Probably working on the road, you know, and not, we've been traveling a lot because we're a traveling band. So it's been kind of tough because we've been working on the record in the van and in hotel rooms and stuff like that, and you know, we've been having to work with what we have, which is not much when you're on the road because we're traveling. Yeah, there's a couple. Pretty much all of it, actually. That I mean, we're really excited to just put all these new songs out. You know, we've been riding on the EP for a little while now, and we're really excited to just put out something new and fresh, and you know, there's a lot of ideas that we want to get out there into the world.
It feels, I mean, it's really kind of hard to say how it feels, really, but it's, you know, all the biggest, best words you can think of, like, that's how we feel. We're excited, we're pumped, like, we freak out sometimes that we're going to be playing Radio City. They were going to be playing a stadium in, you know, Montreal. It's like, it's pretty insane. But yeah, I mean, it feels like we're where we should be, I think. You know, we're ready for this. Like, we're going to go out there and jump around and be ourselves and enjoy every second.
Well, it's always awesome, like, when you're in the studio, you know, and, like, you're writing a song or, like, you know, you just can't wait to, like, finish the song and get it out there. But then it's like, you know, you sit in a dark room for too long, and you're like, oh, I can't wait to just play this live. And then you get to take it on the road. It's definitely more rock and roll, I think. You know, we all kind of grew up, you know, listening to, I mean, I grew up, like, you know, really into, you know, Led Zeppelin and Nirvana and, you know, the grunge era. You know, they're smashing guitars and lighting things on fire and kicking the drum set over and punching people.
Yeah, we're going to tear that place down.
I don't know. When I picture, like, how the show is going to go, like, in my head, I'm like, oh, I can't wait to just, like, smash something. You know, but we never actually do that. It's just in our heads.
Probably going to Europe together. Like, so far, that was incredible. Just getting on that long flight and knowing we're going over there to tour and do music. Like, and see, like, for Bill and I, it was our first time in Europe. So we were kids in a candy store on that plane.
To Chet Thacker, I've been listening to a lot of Chet Thacker. Yes, I have. I've been listening to Jungle a lot.
Let's see, I'm really liking the War on Drugs right now. They're awesome. And new Ryan Adams is amazing.
Oh, yeah.
We've all been digging that. I'm still listening a lot to the... No, lately, actually, I used to listen to music like all the time, every day, trying to find new stuff. But lately, I've just been watching a lot of movies, a lot of TV shows, just get inspiration from something else, you know. But now I'm kind of getting back into like, oh, I want to find new music. So I usually go on a lot of music blogs and find new music from there, you know. Try to find new bands. Yeah, I like your blog. It's good.
Yeah. Yeah, I grew up in a pizza restaurant. I was bussing tables when I was 6 years old, because my parents had a little mom and pop shop.
They still do. It's one of the best pizzas you've ever had.
Maglio's. We'll have to go there next week.
Yeah,
Maglio's Pizza. But anyway, if I wasn't doing music, I mean, I'd probably be doing that.
Don't start it again.
Yeah, please.
You don't even understand.
I would say we had one suggestion before we decided to go for Grisfog. It was Cops, Cops, Cops.
Oh, yeah, totally.
I still like that one. Yeah.
Somebody's definitely going to steal that from us. I just thought it'd be great if, like, you know, people were like, Cops, 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 Cops. You know, every time they had to say our band name.
It's not bad.
It's actually kind of a cool. Yeah. Somebody's definitely going to steal it now.
And here is Cops, 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 their new single, Hymnals.
I don't hate spiders. Get it.
No, I get it.
Get it.
No, I can't get it. It's
going
down your shirt.
Shut up. I hate spiders.